Hi Pisces, welcome to my channel. So today we are going to do your mid-November reading and we will see what are the guidance messages for you in the middle of the month. Okay, so for those who are new to my channel, a warm welcome to you all, and if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please consider subscribing and hit the bell notification icon as well so that you will be able to get updated about my latest videos. And this is a general reading. It may or may not resonate with all of you, okay? So if you want a personalized reading by me, you can DM me or message me in my Facebook or Instagram page by the name The Magical Aura, or you can also find the link for both of my pages below in the description box, okay? So you can message me over there. So let's see what is there for my Pisces in the middle of November, please. Let's see. So this will be a love-based reading, but if we will get the energies of your health or some work or finances, we will take those energies as well. Okay, so let's see. So at the back of the deck we have the Page of Swords. Alright, so a communication, or I would say a stalker. Somebody is stalking you, Pisces. What is happening? Let's see now. The Hermit, Strength, King of Swords, Virgo, Leo, might be Aquarius energy. Sagittarius, Libra, Taurus energies are also here. Okay, so let's see now. Okay, so your past energies with the Hermit, Strength and King of Swords. So there was a decision which was made by your mind, not by your heart. Okay, so this might be you, might be a person as well over here. So this is an energy of somebody who took that decision, who took that decision with a very strong effort. Okay, so this decision was not just an easy one. It really involved a lot of strength, a lot of efforts, because this was something which was huge. Okay, this was not a minor issue. So your present energies are telling me Ace of Wands, Ten of Swords and Four of Wands. So this is an ending to of something, but a beginning of a new relationship, might be a new job, might be like a reunion as well. So this is an idea which is coming into fruition, because the idea, this is the card of an idea which is in your mind with the Ace of Wands, but which you are actually, you know, coming towards the fruition. This energy, this is not yours energy, not your energy. This is somebody else, because you know it's a lot of things which are going in your life right now. It might be a relationship or ending of some bad relationship or bad karma. So this is that energy. Knight of Swords, the World and Three of Cups in your future energies. I just told you that there is an ending towards something, and this is the complete ending. The card with the World card, this is the complete ending. You know, the advice from the tarot over here is that do whatever you have started, always try to finish it first before entering towards another thing. So it might be a relationship, might be a job, anything. So, you know, you might be even writing a script for your film or your book, anything. So try to end the things first. Try to end the past issues first before entering towards something new. Always do that. Okay, so let's see what are the clarification cards tell us now. So why the Page of Swords is over here? So I'm really getting that somebody is trying to contact you as well. There's somebody who is trying to communicate with you as well, and something is really, you are busy, or your person over here, or somebody is busy over here. So, you know, being busy but still trying to communicate with someone whom you have a long bond, a beautiful bond before. Somebody is trying to communicate with the star. Somebody is trying to wish for something. It might be you or might be a person. A wish which is coming true. Okay. Let's see why the hermit is there in your past energies. Four of cups. So this is also telling me that, you know, when you try to have a chat or a talk with somebody who was always close to your heart, but that person has become silent now. So a big silence plus a big decision making is seen in your past, because with the King of Swords as well, this person is not just somebody who tries to take decisions from the heart. It is a decision from the mind. With the Five of Cups, regrets, there are emotional disbalance, I would say. A lot of emotional gap between you and your person. This is somebody from past. This is not your present person with whom you are with right now. Some kind of emotional imbalance, a lot of sadness is here. The past is really trying to, you know, focus on yourself. When you try to give yourself 100%, try to do some soul searching as well over here. Okay, so Ace of Wands, Ten of Swords and Four of Wands is in your present. So let me clarify the Ace of Wands. Okay, Ace of Wands with the Death card over here. So this is actually telling me with both of these cards that when you try that I should try something new. I should do related to my relationship, related to a new job. But whenever your idea comes up in your mind, I don't know why is it, but it always seems to you like it is ending. It is not coming to fruition. But there are two things over here, Pisces. There is something which has ended, but something which has started. And this is a very beautiful bond. Might be a new job, it can be relationship, but we are seeing the love reading, so it is more about your love, a person with whom you were always connected, or with whom, you know, you always wanted to live a life with, or somebody new it can be, but someone who is very close to your heart and you want to be with this person. Let's see why the Ten of Swords is here. Why the Ten of Swords is in the present for my Pisces. What is this Ten of Swords, please? What is this Ten of Swords? Three of Pentacles, yes. It might be a third party relationship which was in between. Yes. Strong energy of third person in your life, but it is ended. Third person. Let's see why the Knight of Swords is here in your future energies. Let's see. Knight of Swords, please. What is this Knight of Swords? Queen of Swords. Okay. Somebody might be dealing with a divorcee or a widow. Somebody independent. You know, there's a communication with this person, with the Devil. Okay, so this is a very strong bond with this person of yours. Queen of Swords with the Devil in your future energies. So this is a very strong bond. You don't want to end this relationship if you are in this kind of a relationship. It can be somebody who is very bold. It can be someone who is very cold-hearted as well, okay, because of the past experiences. So that is why it can be someone who with whom you share really good bond, but still, you know, this person or you, it can be you as well. It does not have to be someone else only. So it is like in both the ways that you and this person of yours is, you know, in that bond where a lot of cold heartedness is there. Somebody is really not saying yes to you. Okay, let's see why the World is here. World card, please. Why the World is here. The future energies for my Pisces. The Emperor. Okay, somebody who is very stubborn. Okay, with the Seven of Wands. A person who is independent, who knows how to fight for herself or himself. So it is a very beautiful bond with whom you have actually you have started this new beginning with someone. It is a bond which is very karmic, I would say, because with the devil I'm seeing a lot of karma, a lot of bad past toxic energies, but this was really the bad things before. But coming up, I'm seeing that a lot of, you know, boldness is there in your relationship. Let's see why the Three of Cups is here in your future energies. Eight of Swords and Nine of Pentacles. As I already said, that it might be you with the Nine of Pentacles. You know, somebody who is very independent, somebody who knows how to take decisions in his or her life. With Eight of Swords, this is not the person with whom you are right now. This can be the person with whom you were in the past energies. A lot of positive energies are coming up, Pisces, for you. Let's see, what else do we have for Pisces? Anything else, please? Ten of Swords at the Moon. So past energies are really coming to an end. With the Moon, I'm seeing that, you know, some things are hidden and you don't know why they are not coming up to the surface, but some things are hidden and they are ending. So hidden things coming to an end is a very good thing for you. So whatever, see, this is more about, I don't feel such a negative card with the Moon, but I don't know why today it is the feeling of this is, you know, with the full moon of this October, it is coming up in, sorry, November, 30th November, with the full moon, end will be there, okay? The endings are coming and it will be, you know, whatever, the toxins are coming to an end, the toxic relationships. All right, so that is all from my side, Pisces. I hope this helps and we will meet you in the next video. Till then, bye.